Hey guys, what's going on? Today I'm going to show you how to replace the battery of your key fob. In my particular case, this is for a Nissan 370Z, but for sure this works for all Nissans, all Infinities, and the same concept should apply to pretty much all key fobs. If yours is any more complex than this, just look up the video specific to your key. Otherwise, let's get right into this. So what you're going to need is a mini tool set, because you need a very thin flathead screwdriver to do this. I'm going to get one out of here. The thinnest one in the pack. This appears to be the thinnest one. So let's get started observing the key. So first off, you want to take the actual key out of the key fob. So to do that, pull this switch down and pull this part out. Move that switch to the open position. Just pull this thing right out. Now that it's out, you want to find the seam, which splits it open in half. You can see that the seam runs right down the middle. So we're going to stick the flattest flathead screwdriver that I have. And you're going to just start trying to pry it open. What I like to do is stick the flathead in there, then twist it a little bit so that it makes it open. And try to hold it with my nail. Then you just pop the whole thing open just like that. So after you've taken out the battery, you want to see what kind of battery it is. You can see that this is a CR2032 3-volt battery. I like the brand Energizer because it lasts longer than any of the other ones that I've used this far. And they're reasonably priced. So after you see what kind of battery you need, go buy one. And I don't recommend you get the cheapest one you can find. Those will only last a few months, and then you have to do this process all over again, which can be a hassle when you're somewhere and your key isn't working. So now put this battery aside and get a replacement, and then you can just reverse the steps to put it back together. So here's the base of the key fob. I'm gonna put the battery in the same way it was facing. And then I'm gonna get the top part of it, align it perfectly, because if you don't, it won't go in right and you could damage it. Then just click it down everywhere that it has a clip until it's fully reassembled. Replacing your own key fob's battery, even if done with the best battery, will only cost you about $5, which is significantly cheaper than going to a dealership to get it done or going to someone who specializes in keys. Now that we've put the control back together, let's see if it works. All right, so we're all good to go. Make sure you guys like, comment, and sub. I'll see you guys next time.